Welcome back to another video, everyone. I'm going to be discussing a brand new concept just unveiled by S&S Sansei, the same amusement ride firm behind this year's Steel Curtain and Max Force roller coasters, the former having won Best New Ride of 2019 in Amusement Today's Golden Ticket Awards. The Axis coaster basically consists of a car that sits above the track and has a swivel arm which extends to hold the seat, as you can see from these videos. The best way to describe it is probably how Amusement Today described it with this quote: "Using comfortable vest restraints as seen on the company's 40 Freespin, seating on Axis places riders on an elevated swivel with feet dangling above the track. Depending on the bank and swoop of the curves, the speed initiates swing, flips, or a sensation of flight." These off-ride videos and POV have been shared to demonstrate how this model actually works, and it is pretty fascinating. The track itself for this prototype model actually maneuvers through a couple inversions and high-speed turns. As you can see, the swivel arm on the car, which is attached to the seat, actually spins and flips based on the banking and twisting of the track. Some people were very quick to point out that the Axis model is actually somewhat similar to a model that S&S had already introduced, known as the Freefly. While this is true, the Freefly model features very minimal, almost non-existent restraints, and cannot perform inversions. To date, only one Freefly model has ever been built, and this is known as Trainan, located at Skara Summerland in Sweden, and it opened in 2009. One very glaring issue that I see as a major problem with both the Freefly and Axis is the capacity. Presumably, the Axis will only be made with one-car trains like on Trainan, which only has a capacity of 900 riders per hour. This is definitely a big downside for large parks, so I don't think we will see many of these coming to any larger parks. I don't know exactly how marketable these coasters will be either. With only one Freefly ever opening, which was 10 years ago at this point, and the Axis model being somewhat similar and having a low capacity as well, I don't exactly predict a lot of parks very willing to invest in something like this. Of course, maybe it is a very cheap model and could serve as a great, unique, thrilling coaster for many small parks. In that case, I think it could serve its purpose well. We have seen S&S really trying to push their new coaster concepts lately, having two major additions to the US in 2019 in the form of a new air-compressed launch coaster and their first hyper coaster. I think this new addition to the S&S portfolio is being rolled out at this time for very good reason, seeing all of the success they have had with their recent major coasters. As mentioned though, I am a bit skeptical, however, given that the Freefly didn't amount to anything more than one small model being built, and I've barely heard anything about that, so I don't know how successful that was in terms of ride experience and for the particular small park. I think the additional Axis introduced with the Axis model could maybe be enough of a push to really show parks that this will be a worthwhile investment, but again, I think it will be approached very cautiously by any future buyers. One thing I really wonder about with the Axis is the maintenance, as it is quite advanced. I feel like parts may be harder to repair as needed, and this could be a deterrent for parks if this is actually the case. But I honestly don't know, it is just a thought after watching how these vehicles work. Personally, after looking at the footage provided of their prototype model running, I think this ride looks like it could certainly be a very fun concept and be a great addition for a lot of smaller parks out there looking to introduce a unique coaster without having to spend a ton of money, presuming this is a cheap model. I could see this model either being a success or just a failure and maybe only seeing one build as we saw with the Freefly. I don't think the Axis is going to be a high thrill coaster, but more of a moderate level family thrill type of experience with a broad appeal, which is definitely something going for this model. I could also see it potentially serving as more of a thrill coaster as well though, albeit nothing too extreme given the nature of its design. What are your personal thoughts about the new Axis coaster introduced by S&S? Will it be the next big trend in the industry with models springing up everywhere, or will it be doomed due to its capacity and potential maintenance uncertainty? Why do you think that either way? I'm curious about your thoughts upon seeing this model, so be sure to leave your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like it and subscribe for more roller coaster and amusement park content if you haven't already. Be sure to like my Facebook page, Coaster Daddy, and follow me at Coaster Daddy Official on Instagram. This is Coaster Daddy. Bye.